on the floor for the visiting Atlanta Hawks. At center, Miles Plumlee. At small forward, Taurean Prince. At the other forward position, Ersan Ilyasova. At shooting, Kent Bazemore. At the other guard position, Dennis Schroeder. The head coach of the visiting team is Mike Budenholzer.
The Hawks, and they're doing business on the road in an interconference NBA game. Happy holidays, everyone, from all of us at 2K Sports. And do we have a present for you today? This is Kevin Harlan, along with Doris Burke and Greg Anthony. On the sideline, we'll be hearing from David Aldridge. This game marks the end of this stretch at home for the Suns. Back on the road tomorrow. They've struggled game after game to secure wins. It's been a tough haul, but they've had to feel like this game provides them a good chance to win.
And right now for Phoenix, they haven't made any of the strides they were hoping to see prior to the season. Again, hanging around at the bottom of the standings.
And with one eye already on the offseason, I would guess they start tinkering with lineups, different personnel combinations as the season wraps up. That way they can start forming a plan for the future.
A look at Atlanta's opening lineup. Filling out the wings, it's Bazemore and Prince. Plumlee out there with Ilyasova. And it's Schroeder in at the point guard.
And the Hawks in the last couple seasons with some roster turnover, established veterans departing, and now with Millsap leaving, they have embraced a complete rebuild.
No good with the triple. Three on three. Here's Ulis. Great D that time from Dennis Schroeder. Atlanta's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Got a piece of it. And as it goes out of bounds, Atlanta able to keep the ball here.
Playing with lots of energy here, trying to cause turnovers.
I love the tenacity right now. Definitely on the prowl, looking for every opportunity to make a steal. The other team has got to be sharp.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. About halfway into the season, Doris, teams are already separating themselves from the pack. What are some of the elements you are looking for right now as you take a look at those top teams and trying to figure out a championship contender?
So you know that line, it's about the economy, stupid. It's about the players, right? You got to have players. You got to have stars. The contending teams always have at least two or three stars. So let's begin there. The other part is you've got to have the right role players around the stars. Think about the Draymond Greens. Think about the Kevin Loves. guys in those positions that are in support of maybe the guys who have the ball in their hands, Steph Curry, Kevin Durant, LeBron James. There's got to be an unselfishness, a professionalism, a commitment, all the things that make championships possible on any number of levels.
He hits both from the stripe. And now, just over a minute played here in the first. Suns have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. There's a good screen. There's Ulis. Good ball movement here by the Suns. Chris gets the bucket.
This is what you want from Marquese Chris, right? Battling inside, challenge the defense. Nice work.
Prince kicks it over to Schroeder. Plumlee, the pass to Schroeder. And Dennis Schroeder out of Germany handed the keys as the full-time starter at the point guard in his fourth season.
And with his confidence and competitive spirit, you know, he was chomping at the bit for that opportunity. And you got to love his athleticism coupled with that big play capability. It's just exciting to see how good this young man can become.
The first one falls.
And up and down the Suns roster, there is a ton of youth. One of the younger teams in our league last season, and that was weighted with Tyson Chandler's age. A lot of young players looking to make their mark here in the NBA.
Schroeder hits them both.
Boy, he's just been so consistent, right? I mean, every time he's gotten to the stripe, he's delivered. This is great stuff.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Well, I caught up with Phoenix's head coach. He told me this is a fun night trying to slow down a team that's so smart and opportunistic. He said, look, we've scouted them, but this is the first time we've actually seen them this season. So it will be interesting to see if we can disrupt their offense and slow them down just a little bit. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the report, David. So it's about one key area, guys, keeping the opposing field goal percentage to a minimum.
And, Kevin, that's not an easy task against an opponent that can shoot the ball as well as this team can.
Well, true, Greg, but they can do it as long as they're quick with their defensive help on the perimeter. And I think a key to that, communication.
And Chris throws it down.
How exciting is this kid? One of the more athletic front court players you'll find in the NBA. Marquese Chris doing work.
And last season, the Suns broke their franchise record for the youngest starting five the team has ever put on the court on multiple occasions.
Yeah, and with those young lineups, you could see the benefits, but also the concerns. I mean, they got a lot of extended looks at young players, and this team figures to have a bright future. But let's face it, there were some inconsistent stretches because of that youth. It's always difficult for a young group to learn how to become efficient and effective in the half court. And guys, this is what you like to see early on, gaining a little confidence from range.
Right, you like the mindset so far, Greg. If you give them room to drain it, they'll do just that.
And where's the help? Obviously a missed rotation, something they're going to want to patch up.
Right, because otherwise you're going to give up those close range opportunities all night. If you allow the opposition to get into a groove, look out.
Hazemore misses. The Suns trail. Outside Jackson. Warren sets the pick for Ulis. The feed to Warren. He dishes it to Monroe. That doesn't go on the chance to tie.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Hawks lead by 2. 2K Sports, back to Phoenix after this. Now we got a close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And for the Hawks, guys, what stands out to you stats-wise?
They've gotten to the line with tremendous consistency here through the first period.
And this is why coaches say be aggressive. As long as you're playing smart, good things tend to happen, even if you're on the road.
This is how the floor looks for the Hawks starting the second quarter. They got Taylor. He's out there with Bellinelli. Collins is out there with Bender. Bellinelli, and that's good. Bellinelli's got the opening basket here in the second quarter for the Hawks. Well, you look back at the history of the Phoenix Suns, and they have had some incredible players suit up for them.
Well, you think Sir Charles, one of the famous names that have played for the franchise, but Steve Nash, Amari Stoudemire, Sean Marion, Dan Majerle, Kevin Johnson. We were talking about some great players.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
Here's Bembry. He averages about 5 points a game. Just five to shoot. It's hauled in by the Suns, coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
Yeah, I thought they came in with an aggressive mindset. Just turns out it was too aggressive.
Right. They fouled way too much, and there's nothing wrong with being physical, but they overdid it in the last game.
Suns trail by three. James outside. Glenn kicks to Bender. Can't tie it up as that one misses. For Atlanta, they've gone one of three to start out the second quarter. The pass to Taylor. Feeds to Collins. Fires for three. It's not going to go for him. Now the Suns take it the other way. And this game, the first chance they've had to see Atlanta.
Yeah, should be an interesting matchup tonight. These two teams will only face off twice all season.
Well, so you want to make these opportunities count, right? Since they don't see each other often, it's going to be an intriguing battle.
Here's Collins. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Bembry from the right block. This shot is good. Doris, they say that one of the toughest things about calling a game is balancing pure basketball knowledge with entertainment. What's your approach with that time?
Do you know that was the last piece of broadcasting that I think fell into place for me? For a long time, I felt like I was proving myself, Kevin, so I didn't relax and enjoy it. But my son one time said to me, when we were watching a game, he said, Mom, you have to understand when the announcers are having fun, we're having fun.
Chemistry is such a big part of it, isn't it?
Crucial.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Now here's Bender. Not a lot of room. Misses the baby hook.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Taylor, score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt.
I'll tell you, good work to pound it down low and finish in tight.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Count it, and the Atlanta lead has been cut down to 6 points. That one good from Daniels.
Boy, defender taken out of the play with a rock-solid screen. No way he's going to get through that.
2 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Now, here's Taylor. The Hawks need to get off a shot here. Out of bounds, Phoenix will take possession. And so it's the Atlanta Hawks with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. Looking good at this point, but wanting more. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Coach, your guys have been able to limit their scoring. How have you done that?
Well, I think our activity, hopefully, in the pick and rolls is making it difficult on them, contesting every shot, denying just our activity in general.
High hands and quick feet. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
The first half in the books. This is Ernie Johnson. This is Shaquille O'Neal. This is Ken Smith. Welcome back.
Ken?
Ken, as we break down the action. a competitive matchup for Atlanta in the first quarter. They saw their lead grow to a high water mark of 5 in the period. Looking at the Hawks, Kenny, what was your take on Atlanta?
Well, they were lighting it up from 3, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screens, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And over to Shaq. What did you think about Phoenix?
I love it. You know why I love it, Ernie? Because they're getting the ball inside and converting, not just sitting back behind the line shooting threes. See, that's kept the defense scrambling a little bit, unable to lock in on anything. Get it in, we'll kick it back out, then you shoot it.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. And Phoenix looking who they've got on the floor. Warren is the 3 while Chris plays the 4. Jackson is out there with Ulis, and it's Monroe in at the center. Here's Ulis after the made shot from Dennis Schroeder. Second chance shot, and there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup, and while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call it a foul shot or not, but sure enough they have. So he'll head to the free throw line. The Suns shooting their first free throw of the night.
And on the season, you know, they're hitting about 76%, which is a decent rate.
The free throw drops for Monroe. And Atlanta has possession. It's a 5-point game, fresh from a win against Portland.
And I was impressed with how comfortable they looked in that environment, made the most of their possessions.
They were extremely efficient, Greg. They ran their offense well and took good high percentage shots. Well, it's not the defense that caused that miss. That one's all on him.
To the inside, Umley with the steal. Here's Prince. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
This is his first free throw of the game.
You know, when you look at his numbers this season, he's had a respectable number, 77%.
Now, gentlemen, 2 shots. Loose shot.
And the first one drops. And both free throws good for Prince. And Doris, so many great point guards in the league. In fact, the number of stars at that position, we see them every night, but who are some of the 4 generals that maybe don't get the headlines? More of the underrated portions.
I think the single most consistently underrated point guard, though certainly not by the contract extension he most recently signed, would be Mike Conley, this guy for the Memphis Grizzlies. Some guys just fit in the systems and the cities and the organizations for whom they play, and I would say Mike Conley, ability to run the team, ability to make the 3-point shot, to make the players around him better, he comes to mind. Kemba Walker in Charlotte is a guy who, once they consistently start to make the playoffs as an undersized point guard, I think you could see him start to grow in reputation. And Isaiah Thomas, who launched himself for stretches into the MVP conversation. Interestingly, Kevin, what do all 3 have in common? A little bit undersized in today's NBA. NBA.
And can you believe Conley has never been an All-Star as good as he is?
Cannot believe that. No, and you've had his teammates make it, Marc Gasol most notably. I know that Marc Gasol would love to see Mike Conley next to him in an All-Star uniform.
Warren kicks to Jackson. Warren on the wing, guarded by Prince. Count it, and the Atlanta lead has been cut to just 3 points on the basket from Warren.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Ilyasova sets a screen for Schroeder. Plumlee, and it's slammed in by Plumlee.
And that's such solid, fundamental basketball on display right there, guys.
You talk about it all the time, Greg. Yeah, great use of the pick to set up the dunk.
You know, that's why we say move without the basketball. You'll be rewarded.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix. A big group substitution here for Phoenix. Tyson Chandler is checked in for Monroe. Logan Bender comes in for Chris. Daniels is checked in for Jackson. And James subbed in for Ulis. James against Schroeder. Dishes to Daniels. Shot clock at 5. Off the pick. And it comes off the front of the rim.
Boy, just enough defensive attention to throw that shot off target.
Nobody near Schroeder. That doesn't go either for Schroeder.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
James kicks to Daniels. Takes the 3. Yes, it's James picking up the assist. Daniels has got 5 now.
Oh, nice screen. Really a poor defensive reaction and the obvious result.
You simply can't give him that. You have to fight through the screen and at least get a hand in the face of the shooter.
Babbitt dishes to Bellinelli. Doesn't go that time. Chandler with the defensive effort. From deep, James, another 3 for Phoenix.
Wow, he doesn't make plays like that very often. That's a nice move inside.
We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Suns ahead as they end the third quarter with a 13-4 run. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. Let's listen in on what Mike Budenholzer had to say to his team in the huddle.
Let's get a stop. Let's play out of motion. Let's run them. Let's play at our pace. Let's go. Defense on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Looking to play at their tempo. Mike Budenholzer really wants them to assert themselves, trying to dominate this next stretch.
Yeah, I mean, his energy is up there, hoping his team's energy is just as high. They may push every chance they get.
And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first 3, we should be in for a treat. On the court for Atlanta, Schroeder and Bellinelli team up in the backcourt. Luke Babbitt is out there with Bembry. And it's Collins in at the center, filling out the middle. Here's Bembry. And it's Schroeder missing.
Yeah, coming off that screen, wide open, just can't convert.
Well, I think, Greg, that's exactly what you want. The screen was solid. The execution just fell a little bit short on the shot.
Chandler's shot good.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Babbitt kicks to Bellinelli. There's the pick. Passes it to Bembry. Stolen by Warren. And oh, here we go. Warren's got it. The fast break chance. That one good for 2. Now it's a 7-point Suns lead.
Oh, fruitful possession. Just doing what they can to extend the lead.
Well, this is a perfect example of how you want to run your offense. Disciplined but determined. Nice possession, Greg.
Atlanta shooting 39% from the floor. At their best. Atlanta calls timeout.
Yeah, he's got to make some adjustments here. Just too easy to score in the lane against them right now.
But, Greg, no resistance, right? They're allowing them to get any kind of shot they want close. That simply can't happen.
Greg Monroe. He's checked in for the Suns. Jackson comes in for Troy Daniels. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Thanks, Kevin. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team during the break. He is not happy with the perimeter defense. He said, guys, our three-point line is too lax, and they're getting wide-open shots. Got to get over screens and get on top of them and get them off the line. We'll see if they get the message, guys.
Here's Warren after the made shot from Dennis Schroeder. Monroe makes it off the glass. Monroe's got the lead back up to seven now for the Suns.
Shakes his man by using exceptional use of the screen. I mean, from there, it's smooth sailing.
It's Schroeder with the drive, and they pick up two.
And that's just a great individual play right through the teeth of the defense.
Ulis passes to Warren. Over Prince. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. Warren's got four this quarter. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. There's Schroeder, and the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
I mean, he is tearing the defense apart, and let's face it, they have not brought their A game on that side of the ball.
Jackson kicks to Monroe. Over Plumlee. Monroe, no good. The Hawks trail by five. Prince in the corner. Schroeder, left side. And the layup is good. Schroeder's got 10 points here in the second half.
Vital basket there. This is just the time and really just the situation when he looks to take over.
There's the pick. Shot off the screen. Good!
Boy, excellent team basketball. Used the screen to free himself up and drill the jump shot.
54 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Prince. Ilyasova sets a screen for Prince. Shot from free throw range. It's good! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
And a lot of scoring here late, but there hasn't been any defense to speak of.
Yeah, this game has not exactly been a coach's delight. Both teams run ragged at the defensive end.
Now here's Bender. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Sheldon. And just an excellent pump fake from the big man Bender, really selling the D.
First free throw is good, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
Now, this is why you love Bender's size, right? At 7'1", fantastic mobility, just incredible.
And so he drops them both. It's a five-point game.
Yeah, two-possession game now after knocking both of those down.
Atlanta calls timeout. They trail by five. 17 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Is what's your take?
It's going to be interesting to see what they draw up to get this quick shot.
Yeah, the clock is definitely not their friend, and they need to score fast.
And now we get the chance to present our Jordan Player of the Game, T.J. Warren.
And his percentage from the field tonight seemed almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
Schroeder, and he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Shooting from the middle, Dennis Schroeder. Two shots.
Shooting two.
He hits the first one, and that shrinks the margin to just four. Hits them both.
And that makes it a one-possession game, guys. Got to be the biggest free throws of the game thus far.
And he commits the intentional foul.
He had to foul, and on that occasion, to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss.
And Jackson certainly has a lot of explosiveness. One of those guys who really wears his heart on his sleeve and brings that energy level every night.
And he ends up making the second, and that gives them a four-point cushion. Schroeder dishes to Plumlee. Bazemore for three. The Hawks again can't hit. They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul.
Shooting for Phoenix, T.J. Warren. At the line for two.
And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall. Trying to focus now on the second. So neither attempt will fall that time for him. Schroeder. So it's the Suns taking the W in a close one. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah, but I really got a sense that the fans gave them that emotional boost that was needed down the stretch. This crowd, man, they were electric.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.